Welcome to another episode of Modern Bar. Thank you for joining me. So today I thought I'd go through Australia's pool journey. But yeah, before we get into it, please comment, please share, please like, and let's get the conversation going down below. So Australia play Fiji in their first game. History has been on Australia's side for sure. Not a lot of recent games. They've won 4, drawn and lost none. The last game they've played was in 2017 with a 23-point win to Oz. Before that was 2015 with a 15-point and 46-point back in 2010. But that is, I'd say, an outlier. I think the Fiji's team is much more like the last two games. Although, to be fair, Australia also haven't had great times in those periods, especially those years which we're talking here. So it'll be interesting to see. That 2015 game was in a World Cup and shows the pride Fiji bring to a World Cup, so I think that's a much safer bet. The average of the last 4 games is 32 points. I think that's a little bit on the high side. I would be much closer to the 15 to 20 mark if I'm doing Super Brew or betting, considering Australia are definitely peaking, I think, going into this World Cup. But Fiji have a lot of bruisers that definitely will be able to perform. And it depends completely on the kind of Australian team that arrives on the day, in my opinion. Next, they take on Wales. So the Welsh game, I think, is probably the most hotly contested game of this tournament. I am quite excited for it. I think that's going to be a beautiful game. Australia-Wales. As an Australian fan, you'd be looking forward to this game as your history leans your way. You've won the last 9 out of 10 games with only one loss, that obviously being the most recent game, as it could be a nice revenge win for Australian fans, boost a lot of confidence in the team, as Wales is definitely a team to beat at the moment. As they are, the results, 3-point win to Wales. Before there was an 8-point win to Australia and a 24-point win to Australia. I think you're probably looking much closer to the 8-point win for Australia, although the average over the last 5 games is 17 points. So yeah, I don't know what to make of that. Both teams have really upped the ante this year, especially Gatland's men. So it depends completely on, can Australia pull the performance they did in the first Bledisloe game or the second Bledisloe game? Unfortunately, I've always felt Australia are the kind of team that it depends on if their star performance are performing, otherwise the team can't sometimes perform if they don't have their stars performing. So that'll be interesting to see. Next, Australia take on Uruguay, probably the easiest game of their pool. They've only really played them once before, back in 2015 Cup, World Cup, and that was a 62-point win, so the average effectively there being 62 points. Probably not a bad bet to go around there again, especially if Australia are trying to blood some players. Players are trying to put their hands up for the quarterfinals and semi-final teams. So an interesting game, and I think it should be a tri-fest, honestly. I'm sorry to say that, Uruguay fans, but it should be a tri-fest for Australia, and definitely a way to, especially if that Australia-Wales game goes badly, a way to get points difference up if needed. Then the next game, a great game. Georgia are always a fun team to watch. I've said this in other videos. They bring everything to the game. They play with a lot of heart. And as an Australian team, I'd definitely be afraid of that. They've put a lot of heart. They've never played each other. So there could be a great precedent set for Georgia to effectively do the sad history, the sad story of the miracle in Brighton story of first time playing a world leader and you demolish them, like Japan did to Australia. I will have to see. I hope for Georgia in some ways, but Australia definitely, this is a game for them to win, or a game that they must lose, not a game that Georgia are going to go and give everything. Australia need to make sure they take the points that are on offer. But yeah, that's my opinion of Australia's pool journey. Please let me know what you think. Please comment down below. Please share, and let's get the conversation going. Thanks, guys.